not working.
Alright, well, we're gonna use that one for some of the permits. We'll just go with the technology that we know is working, because we know that is working. So, welcome to Jackson Community Church. I think most people here are familiar with us. And we start with announcements, and then we go to passing of the peace, because we like to unseat you. And before we begin, though, I want to welcome Heather Pierson and Reverend Bernice Martin, who are our worship leaders this morning. So this is an unusual and a very fun service for us. And we enjoy having all of you participate with us in the service of song. But let's begin this morning with any announcements for the life of the church or the community. Joyce and Mike. Okay, so first announcement of the day. Many of you might remember that we had a minister here for a while named Joyce Scott. She did some of the children's programming, if you had kids that were old enough for that. And she worked alongside Po Jen. She went on to become a minister at other churches, and she is now doing the work of disaster relief with her husband. This is a joint ministry that they're doing together. They kitted out their vehicle, and they live out of their vehicle, and they go all over the country, and they work to lead disaster relief teams. So they're trained to actually mobilize whole groups of volunteers in wake of hurricanes and floods and things like that. We have chosen to support their work as a church, so the missions team will be making a contribution to them, and you'll be seeing by email that we'll send out their information. If this is something that's of interest to you, you are more than welcome to match what we're doing or, you know, just make a donation of whatever kind you want towards their ministry. This will probably be an annual contribution that we will make towards supporting their work. It's another set of feet on the ground, doing good work, right where it's needed, and we can't all be out there doing that. So it's wonderful to support those who feel called to do this. I mean, happen to know this family, and Gloria Hutchings personally interviewed them, I personally interviewed them, and we can tell you that this is a wonderful contribution, or a wonderful cause to be supporting. Other announcements? Meg?
Oh yes, I pushed the model. Here, I'm your model. So I just came back from Honduras Wednesday.
Okay.
And I do have two of my favorite baskets from the 100-and-something baskets that we bought from the ladies. Friday. And so these are our new collection plates for them. So I thought this would help you keep on your soul in your mind and your heart. And yeah, some of our favorite basket purchasers I think she said shopping today. Anyway, it was a wonderful service trip, and I will certainly put out a program to let everybody know all that went on. I thank all of you who contributed money and toothbrushes before I went, and several of you contributed from my Facebook postings when I was there, and I was really grateful. And the whole team in Honduras was very grateful for the contributions of the Jackson Church.
Right. So we're going to try this again. Is it working now?
Yes.
No.
Working?
No.
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 Oh, there we go. All right. Magic. So, my husband can fix anything. Other announcements for the life of the community or the church. I'm going to remind us that we have a 3:30 racial justice conversation beginning at the library this Sunday. This is a 6-week series. If you can come, it's great to start at the first one, but if you absolutely can't come because you have to be like at the blessing of this cross-country ski trails at 3:30 or 3 o'clock or whatever, join us next week. We're going to be there every Sunday for the next 6 weeks. Working on racial justice. Yes.
I just want to remind everybody that we have an upcoming event, fun. It's going to be Fat Tuesday. It'll be on Tuesday. That's good. And it will be here at the church. There will be lots of good food and such. But I just want you to mark your calendars. And we'll probably need some help too. Because many hands make the work go light. I've only got one.
Yes, so Sue, who is our one-handed cook, is reminding us about Fat Tuesday, which is on February 25th. And I know that because Heather's going to be playing over at the Stone Mountain Arts Center, doing amazing jazz over there. And we're going to be doing some jazz over here. So you have multiple options, and either one is an excellent choice. But put it on your calendar one way or another for Fat Tuesday. Other announcements? Did I miss anything? Okay. Then this is the chance for you guys to, are we doing pass the peace today? Yeah, let's pass the peace first. Make friends, get up, elbow bump.
Words this morning, Reverend Archibald Gamble. Our song, arises out of that which is holy. In our opening song, can we get that from the
book? Yeah, can everyone have
access to one? You might not have one yourself, you have one you can share.
Raise your hand if you need a book. Alright, so you're going to have to cuddle up with somebody that already has a book. So get friendly if you don't already have a book. Join somebody who does. Do you guys have a book?
Every o'clock, and they asked us to pray for Tom asked us to pray for the life of Dr. Katz, who passed away, and also to please hold up the family of Serafina. We were doing her meal tray. Some of you were probably even signed up to deliver meals, and she died this week. And so she leaves behind a sixth grader and a third grader, and a very broken-hearted community. So we hold her family in our prayers. We lift up gratitude for her life, but we also say it was too short, and her children needed her longer. So we are sorry and sorrowful for that news. We also have somebody actually who's in front of a cardiologist right now with an emergency. So we ask for your prayers for the folks, the beating hearts of some of our congregation who are in need of immediate care. And we pray for people who have very brand new cancer diagnoses that are quite aggressive or uncertain that require attention. And we also pray for people who are struggling with mental health, because we've had one family touched by a suicide attempt this week that was quite serious again. So lots of pain in this world right now, and pain touches pain. So please, you know, if you're able to share your pain, this is a good place to bring it. And then we try to carry it together instead of alone. Are there other people that have prayers of concern first, and then we'll move to celebration and try to move the energy from heavy to hopeful? Are there prayers of concern, Kevin?
Prayer for Sue, who's arm is hurt. Prayer for Jeanette for good health. Prayer for Reverend Gail. Prayer for Ben, my friend, who had colon cancer. I guess there's something, a complication that showed up years later that he's going to have to get treated. So prayer for him. Prayer for his sister, as I must. Prayer for my other neighbor, forgot his name. I think it's Sam, his sister, as I must too. And, I just wanted to also say that, I've never been to a church like this before, and I've been to a lot of churches, and it's a very special church. And also, I'll say really quick, I tell everybody about Reverend Gail, and some of them are just common people, but some of them are important people, like I met this guy from the Supreme Court in New Hampshire. Or is it Dartmouth Hitchcock? I'll say it out great, Reverend Gale. And then this other lady I met from Cambridge, Massachusetts, I came by, and I told her how smart Reverend Gale was, and she went, wow. And lastly, I'll say, I'm trying to get this cat, Lily, who's injured, has her paw. And like I told those kids, I want to get it because Reverend Gail showed me love when I was damaged. So I want to show this cat love, and I want to see it to love. So prayers that I'll get cat.
Lots of prayers from Kevin for people living with MS, for Sue's healing wrist, because she had surgery this week. For a cat named Lily that he hopes to become a home for, that Lily will find the right home, whatever that might home may be, and lots of other prayers. Other prayers from this community. Another person that we mourn, Kevin Dunman, and gratitude for the life that he lived that touched so many people, that sorrow again. when our lives, our bodies are vulnerable and hope too soon. And the prayers too.
Keep in mind our friend Steele, as her path takes another turn, and we're not sure where that's going, but remember her. And I also want to say prayers of thanksgiving for the wonderful care that and the love that I received from this house and all that dwell in it. It's a special place.
So prayers for Steele, who is a member of our community living with cancer and recurrence of cancer, and prayers of gratitude for being part of this community and knowing that you are loved and that there is someone who cares about you and we take care of each other. And a prayer. We also ask for prayers of joy because we need a whole lot of joy and hope in order to carry the hard parts of life that we hear about. And the prayers that I got already this morning at 8 o'clock were gratitude for that beautiful full moon, both in its setting and its rising and its setting. Prayers of gratitude for the light through the ice and the, you know, just the glittering mountains and the amazing sunlight that we had in the aftermath of the storms. And Tin Mountain mentions to us that they have a very rare bird that has found some shelter down there. It is a female painted bunting, and it's quite rare. It is from Texas. It has no business being up here. It got blown here or got confused. I was showing up at the feeder there, and so everybody's watching it, and everybody wants them to kind of like interfere, but they're going to just hope that the bunting survives, and they'll do their best to help it, but they will let it live its natural life. Juncos, too, apparently missing some juncos. So we are grateful for birds. Birds that shouldn't be here and birds that are here, and that our birds find just the perfect sanctuary because you couldn't find a better place to land than Tin Mountain if you're going to get lost. Prayers of joy. Do other people have prayers of joy? Kevin?
Well, I'm grateful for the sunshine and freedom and just the simple things in life.
Sunshine and freedom and simple things.
I'm just going to say last evening I received a phone call from somebody that we know who just called to say how very, very happy this person was because a year ago this person was in a really bad, bad way and has come along and this person was really happy last night. Totally happy.
Great prayers of gratitude when you can accompany someone on the journey from a place that is hard and dark to a place of happiness and hope and stability. Let us say also prayers for our children who are out in the world, some of whom are serving on active duty in the military, and people around us that took emergency calls today because they're firefighters or police people or EMTs or whatever. People that are called into lines of defense and protection and responding to emergencies. Let us hold them in our hearts and hold them safe and bring them home again. And prayers of gratitude that we have the freedom to vote. And the responsibility as people of faith to vote. Let us take responsibility for this place where we live and use our voices and our votes in ways that are needed. Let us be in prayer. Oh, holy God, you are the God of the rising moon and the rising sun. You are the God that promises light and darkness. And we are grateful for the fierce, beautiful light that is flowing over the snow today and glittering and blinding us a little bit, but giving us hope. We are grateful for the rare sighting of a painted bunting and the common sighting of a junco and the chance to walk and play in the snow and the chance to honor life, to give thanks for life that has come and gone too quickly, the courage to live lives that are challenged by adversity but also enriched by joy and pleasure and simply knowing each other and having the capacity to feel love and to give love. We know that we are called to be your love in this world, and so we ask you to be present to us, that we may be present where we are needed in this world. We ask you to hear our silence. We ask you to hear our voices that we lift up together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. This is a day of song. Let us sing. Yes, we're going to start by thinking about how the scriptures lead us to song. That my bulletin item comes in too. We offer you three very brief scriptures. Psalm 40, verse 3. Love put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise. Psalm 119, verse 54. Love's statutes have been my songs whenever I make my home, and wherever I make my home. Isaiah 55, verse 12. You shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Psalm 3.
So we brought this morning a time for all ages, and we're often reminded to love others as we love ourselves. This song is about that. Love and me.
silence so that I can hear the music. And I need darkness so that I can see the light. And I need the cold so that I can feel the warmth of another's heart. And I need to know what's wrong so that I can do what's right. I need silence so that I can hear the music. And I need darkness so that I can see the light. And I need the cold so that I can feel the warmth of another's heart. And I need to know what's wrong so that I can do what's right. I need to know what's wrong so that I can do what's right.
Let's continue to breathe together. As you breathe in, feel your chest expanding as your lungs fill with air. As you breathe out, allow the tensions of your body to melt away. Breathing in and breathing out. As you breathe in, feel your body expand, nourishing yourselves. As you breathe out, feel your body rest more deeply, releasing all that is no longer needed. Breathing in and breathing out. As you breathe in, quiet your thoughts. As you breathe out, allow the worries of your mind to fall away. Breathing in and breathing out. As you breathe in, feel the quiet growing in your mind. As you breathe out, allow the unfolding peace to fill the deep places of your heart. Breathing in and breathing out. As you breathe in, feel the beating of your heart. As you breathe out, allow the fullness of your being to rest in the sacredness within us, between us, and all around us. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in the peace that enfolds us. Breathing out the blessings of our hearts. Breathing in the peace that enfolds us. Breathing out the blessings of our hearts. May it be so. Blessings. Amen. accept the morning offer for continued work of this congregation and larger community.
I give thanks to my mother, the earth. I give thanks to my father, the sky. I give thanks to my brother, the sun. I give thanks to my sister, the moon. I give thanks for the breath of my soul. I give thanks for the passion that moves me. I give thanks for the waters that nourish me. I give thanks for the earth my home. I give thanks with all the words that I say. I give thanks with all the things that I do. I give thanks from deep within me. I give thanks with every step that I take. I give thanks to my mother, the earth. I give thanks to my father, the sky. I give thanks to my brother, the sun. I give thanks to my sister, the moon.
Please join me in the doxology.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Responsive singing. Bernice and I will demonstrate it first, and you can follow along with the words in the order of service. So we will do it once through, and then we invite you to join with us. If this half of the congregation, this side, could sing with me, and this half sing with Bernice. First, the demonstration.
With this high, right. Once was, and what will be.
next song that we'd like to sing together is number 19. Songbook. It's May Peace Prevail. So I'll sing it through one time, and then everybody can join me as you feel cool.
And we'll sing it until it feels like we're done.
That's how it goes. May peace prevail on
to abandon yourself completely and let the music do as it will with you, to be a vessel through which it passes. Now we're going to teach you a song, a part of a song. This is a song, one of Bernice's, called Pulse of Creation. And there is a fall that she will do, and then we're going to respond to a little thing that goes like this. Hey, hey, ah, hey, ah, hey, ah, hey, oh. Try that. Hey, hey, ah, hey, ah, hey, ah, hey, oh.
Hey, 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 oh.
people ask me how I make music, I tell them I just step into it. It's like stepping into a river and joining the flow. Every moment in the river has its song.
I am guided by the Spirit of love. I am guided by the Spirit of love. In everything I say and do. In everything I say and do. With my heart wide open and free. With my heart wide open and free. Share with you a little bit of our own heart.
hearts in doing this work, and what I'd like to share this morning is the great gift that it is to be able to go into a community and lift our voices together and be able to know one another in a way that we really can't know another except through singing and through our voices and through joining together in community and finding our place wherever that is, in the sound, in the silence, in the raucous, in the peaceful, in the, all of it, to find our place. And music can allow us all to find our place.
If there is one thing that can truly transcend any and all borders, walls, and boundaries, real or imagined, it is the language of music. No matter who you are, or where you come from, or what burdens or joys you carry, music has the capacity to draw you into a harmonious space and hold you there for as long as your heart desires. It is in and from that harmonious space that positive change can come in minds and hearts through the power of song. And what I love, one of the things I love most about doing this work is that we can come to a place where I do recognize some faces, but I don't recognize all of them. And because the language of music allows us to create this container that we can all be together in, for me, it just keeps alive the hope that harmony between friends and strangers is not only possible, but it's already a reality. We're already doing it. So thank you for showing up and doing it with us.
Join in. This is a very simple one. Lift up your heart and rejoice, rejoice. Give all the love in your heart a voice. Lift up your heart and rejoice, rejoice. Lift up your heart and rejoice. Lift up your heart and rejoice, rejoice. Give all the love in your heart a voice. Lift up your heart and rejoice, rejoice. Lift up your heart and rejoice. Lift up your heart and rejoice, rejoice. Give all the love.
Come in peace.
extra time to be done. We have one more song to teach you, and then our closing circle. I thought we would like to kind of make sure everybody who needs to go can go, and if folks want to stay, stay, and we'll move forward. So this next song is called Breathe In Life, and it's number one in the clubs.
As you feel willing and able.